Baptist Church. So good to see you. I feel like it's been a month of Sundays. Come to think of it, it has been 4 whole weeks. Can you believe it? We have not been in this sanctuary for 4 weeks, but we're still able to worship together as one body in Christ, even in our homes through our virtual church campus. And I'm so excited on behalf of our pastor, Pastor Oscar Lloyd Jr., that you logged in and joined with us. And let's go to God in our scripture reading this morning. Coming from Psalm chapter 9, beginning at verse 1. And it says, I will give thanks to the Lord with my whole heart. I will recount all of your wonderful deeds. I will be glad and exult in you. I will sing praises to your name, O Most High. Let's go to God in prayer. Spirit of the living God, we thank you for this opportunity to worship together as a body of believers. God, we thank you that we've been able to stay connected in this virtual experience. God, bless our time of worship together, that we may be able to give your name all the honor, all the praise, and all the glory. Bless all the households that are watching, and bless those persons who have tuned in but have not had a chance to experience your love and your grace. May something that is said or done or spoken touch their hearts, God, they may come into relationship with you. These and all the blessings we ask in the mighty and matchless name of Jesus Christ, we do pray. Amen. Let's go to God in worship after this.
Greetings, everyone. I am affectionately known as Dr. J, the Executive Director of the Hope Center of Carmody Hills. Carmody Hills Hope Center is located within Carmody Hills Baptist Church in Seat Pleasant, Maryland. I am back to bring you a word of encouragement by popular demand. The world is still in a pandemic crisis. And by now, we have probably experienced some types of loss. Loss of a loved one, loss of someone we knew, loss of our job, loss of finances, and even loss of freedom in general. But even in the uncertain times, you must find that moment that indicates hope for you. For example, for me, I don't watch the news, I read the news. However, this week I had a chance to see the news and I saw a caption of two young Beijing, China children seeing each other for the first time since their lockdown. They ran to each other from afar, they hugged each other, they squeezed each other tightly, and they exchanged laughter. That was a moment of hope for me. It reminded me that this will end. There is a light at the end of this uncertain tunnel. So, my challenge for you this week is to find that moment of hope, mentally capture it, hold on to it, and share that story until we meet again.
Good morning. Certainly we thank God again for another great opportunity to be in the land of the living. Just one more day. Certainly we serve a good God. We serve a great God. We serve a powerful God. A God that who has not left us. A God that is continuing to keep us. And my brothers and sisters out there, I don't know about you, but I'm grateful that we have a God that cares. I want to invite your attention to the book of Luke, the 5th chapter, verses 19 through 26. And it reads, "But finding no way to bring him in, because because of the crowd. They went up on the roof and let him down with his bed through the tiles in the midst before Jesus. And when he saw their faith, he said, "Man, your sins are forgiven you." And the scribes and the Pharisees began to question, saying, "Who is this who speaks blasphemies? Who can forgive sins but God alone?" When Jesus perceived their thoughts, he answered them, "Why do you question in your hearts? Which is easier to say, your sins are forgiven you, or to say, rise and walk? But that you may know that the Son of Man has authority on earth to forgive sins," he said to the man who was paralyzed, "I say to you, rise, pick up your bed, and go home." And immediately he rose up before them, picked up what he had been lying on, and went home, glorifying God. And amazement seized them all, and they glorified God and were filled with awe, saying, "We have seen extraordinary things today." Father, our God, we thank you, we worship you, we magnify your name, we celebrate you, God, because you're great. We celebrate you, God, because you are marvelous. We celebrate you, God, because you're still alive. God, we thank you for being a good God, a great God, a merciful God, a God that still heals, a God that still hears, and a God that is still performing miracles today. Now, God, I pray as I stand this morning, pray, God, that you will use me mightily, that you will get the glory from this, and that we will praise you in spite of. It is in Jesus' name we pray. Let us say, amen. Thus I keep you too long this morning. I want to preach from the subject, witnessing something extraordinary. Witnessing something extraordinary. Witnessing something extraordinary are things that make you say, Something that is extraordinary is something that is unusual or remarkable. I know that many of us can look back over our lives and remember something that was remarkable. When something that took place in your life that was remarkable, it served as a memorial. Even though it was in the past, we must go back and revisit what took place every now and then to appreciate where God has brought us from. The reality is that we must learn how to appreciate and embrace the extraordinary things that take place in the lives of others. However, I just want to be honest, transparent, and clear that everybody that witnessed something extraordinary that has taken place in your life is not going to celebrate with you. People that are so-called your friends will celebrate your disasters before they will celebrate your blessings. It's amazing when your progress is visible. And some people want to make your progress invisible. They will act as if they never saw or heard about your progress. They will never tell you that was a good idea. Keep up the good work. Praying for you. They just don't mention. They're just like your Facebook stalkers, your Facebook stalker friends. They will review your page, see the progress you're making, or the coming attraction to your ministry, and they won't comment or say anything. They will keep scrolling. They won't give you thumbs up. They won't show you no love. They won't laugh. They won't look angry. They won't give you the sign, wow. They totally ignore your page. But beloved, let a negative pop up on your timeline. They will have all kind of kind remarks for you. Beloved, they're saying we're praying for you. Stay strong. Things will get better. Keep your head up. The Lord will see you through. But beloved, people focus more on gossip and chaos than they focus on truly encouraging or authentically helping someone who are in need. However, my brothers and my sisters, God has called us to meet the needs of people. Reality is, my brothers and sisters, everywhere that Jesus went, he met the needs of people. When they were sick, he healed them. When there was turmoil, he brought peace. When there was mental health issues, he provided counseling. When there was injustice, he exercised social justice. The way Jesus skillfully met the needs of people, beloved, it was extraordinary. Here in this text, Jesus heals a paralytic man. Dr. Luke Wright says there was a man that was paralyzed, and they heard that Jesus was in the neighborhood. Knowing that Jesus was in the neighborhood, wherever Jesus was, they know that Jesus will exercise some good signs and some wonders. They decided to get this paralyzed man to see Jesus. Not only did they decide to get this paralyzed man to see Jesus, they was thinking more about the needs of the paralyzed man than they were thinking about their own needs. Here, my brothers and my sisters, these four men began to come together. They began to strategize. They began to place a plan in place so that they can mobilize. And I can imagine, beloved, as they were coming together, that they were all on one accord. Number one, they were working together because they had the same mission in mind. They were mission-minded. And the mission was to get this man to see Jesus. Because they knew if they get this man to see Jesus, Jesus will take care of all of his problems. Can I pause here for a moment, my brothers and my sisters, when we all come together, working together for the common good, and that is to build the body of Christ, we will see more lives being saved. My brothers and sisters, I really appreciate the work that the doctors are doing. I appreciate the work that the nurses are doing. I appreciate the work that the environmental services are doing. We can't leave them out. Because if it had not been for those cleaning, the floors wouldn't be germ-free. The gowns would not be germ-free. I stop by to tell somebody on today, not only the doctors are important, not only are the nurses important, but the environmental services people, they are important as well. Yeah, yeah. They all have a different role. They're working together. So beloved, they began to work together. They began to mobilize the plan that they had in place. Because this man was paralyzed. Can you just use your own imagination with me? As I use my own imagination, I can imagine that there was a crowd of people there. And everybody wanted to come to see Jesus. And the reason that they wanted to come to see Jesus, because they had issues of their own. They had problems that they were dealing with on their own. And they knew if they just get in front of Jesus, that Jesus will take care of all of their problems. But these men, they said, here it is, this man has been paralyzed for a long time. We got to get this man to see Jesus. And beloved, they came together, they had this particular plan in place. They had a mission, and the mission was to go and get this man to see Jesus. My brothers and sisters, one was on the left side, one was on the right side, and one was in the front, and one was on the opposite of the front, and they began to carry this man towards to see Jesus. And as they began to carry this man to see Jesus, they began to look around to try to figure out how in the world we can get this paralyzed man in the building to see Jesus. My brothers and sisters, they began, number two, to think outside of the box. And as they began to think outside of the box, they saw a set of stairs. And they said, look, my brothers, if we can only just get this man up those stairs, and we can use some ingenuity, we can get this man down to the roof in order to see, get them in front of Jesus so that he may get healed. These men, they didn't argue. They didn't fight like we do. They didn't shout at each other like we do. They hung on in there. accolades for them. They understood that they had to think outside of the box because they had to get this man inside to see Jesus. And now they began to take this man to the upper room, if you will. They began to climb up the stairs. They began to pull. They began to take breaks. They began to sweat, but they never let this man fall. They was able to persevere till they got this man to the top of the roof. And when they got him to the top of the roof, they were able to lower the man down. And once they got the man down, they got him in front of Jesus. And once you in front of Jesus, whatever problems you may have, whatever issues you may have, whatever sickness you may have, Jesus, he will work it out. Just give your problems over to the Lord. And I know many of us have cabin fever. I know many of us have been in the house for weeks at a time. But it's time for you to think outside of the box. Because you can't be confined to where you are. You have to find some things on the inside of your house, in your backyard, in your community, so you can go out and release your cares. So my brothers and sisters, they got this man before Jesus because they were thinking out of the box. But how many know, I'm just so excited that technology certainly exists, because we were able to think outside of the box, to make sure that we stay connected, to make sure that we stay engaged, to make sure that we can still connect with family and friends. I'm so glad that we were able to think outside of the box. Brothers and sisters, this paralyzed man came before Jesus, and questions were began to raise. And I know that many of us have a lot of questions. God, where are you in the midst of this pandemic? God, how long will it be before you wash this earth and purify it and make it clean again? I know many of us are raising questions. God, how long? My loved one has died. My friend has died. My enemy even died. But God, how long will this pandemic be upon us? And I know that you have some questions. Beloved, but just continue to let the Lord work it out, because it won't be long here. The saints, they raised questions, and they said in verse 23, what is easier to say? Your sins are forgiven you, or to say, rise and walk. As they began to raise questions by verse 24, but they say, but the Son of Man has the authority. He has the authority on earth to forgive sins. He said to the man who was paralyzed, I say to you, rise, pick up your bed, and go home. My brothers and sisters, too many of us are being paralyzed by this pandemic. I dare you to stand up, pick up your bed, and celebrate God, because he will bring us through. I want to have some witnesses out there. Can just tell their neighbor that he will bring you through. He may not come when you want him to come, but he will show up on time, because that's the type of God that we serve. And not only will he show up, the God that we serve, he will show out. Because the text said he healed this paralyzed man. And this paralyzed man, he began to walk around. He began want you to go back to your home and show them what I've done. And the reality is, all of us got some type of testimony where God has brought us from a mighty long way. Can you just look back over your life and see where God has brought you from? God has brought you from a mighty long way. Can I get a witness up in here? And verse 26 says, not only were they glorifying God, our third point is we have to celebrate the moment. My brothers and sisters, verse 26 teaches us how we ought to celebrate the moment. Because an amazement seized them all. They was excited about what they saw. I said amazement seized them all. And when you're happy, you don't have nothing else to do. All you have to do is just put your hands together. Begin to run where you are. Because you have experienced some amazing things in your life. My brothers and sisters, they began to glorify God. And they were filled with awe, saying, We have seen some extraordinary things today. I stop by to encourage all of our watchers today. I stop by to encourage all of our viewers today. Because we're about to see something extraordinary. Because God is not through with us yet. Can I get a witness up in here? Because when God shows up, he will show up in his own time. And when he decides to clean up this mess, he's going to clean it up when he feel like cleaning it up. But I wish we had some folk that had some premature praises. Even though the things are not cleaned up, you have to have a praise on your lips. Just because things are not cleaned up, when you wake up in the morning, you just ought to throw your hands up in the air and wave them like you don't care and celebrate the Lord, because he woke you up this morning and he started you on your way. I wish I had about five people out there that are viewing this show right now, not only this show, I'm sorry, that is viewing this service, that you just put your hands together and celebrate the Lord, because the Lord God, he's been too good to us. Is there anybody in here ever had some amazing things that took place in your life? Can you just wave your hand and clap your hands wherever you are and tell the Lord thank you? Because the Lord delivers some of us from places we had no business. That was amazement, because some folk thought you could have been dead, because some folk counted you out. Oh. like he's already worked it out. Beloved, sooner or later, we're going to witness something extraordinary. Continue to pray. Continue to remain hopeful, because God will do something extraordinary. Lastly, when he brings us out of what we're experiencing, what will be your response? What will be your response? Father, my God, we thank you. We worship you. We magnify you. We pray for your strength. Pray for your power. We pray for your healing. We pray for those of us who are dealing with paralysis, fear, doubt, question after question. How long? God, would you? God, will you hear our prayers? And God, will we will honor you with a great response once our prayers have been answered. Not only God, once our prayers have been answered, we are honoring you with a great response, even now. Certainly just put our hands together for the Lord, and certainly Common Hills Baptist Church, we pray, just a reminder that you will go on out multiple ways that you can give back into, sow back into your ministry. You know what those ways are. So we just want to encourage you just to do so. At this time, we know that you're going on RAM. You know that you can use our Cash App and so forth. You know that you can mail your tithes and your gifts to this ministry. So certainly we thank you and we thank God for you.
Wasn't that a blessed worship experience? And wasn't that a mighty, powerful word from our pastor? Listen, we want to stay connected with you. We ask that you would please go to our website, www.carmelyhills.org/connect, to log in to find out how you can connect with us to our Bible studies and all of our services and special events. Listen, we've got Monday nights Bible Institute classes at 7 p.m. On Wednesdays at 11:30 a.m., we have our Young at Heart experience. And then Wednesdays at 7 p.m., our virtual prayer meeting. We want to encourage you to stay connected with us as we go to God, even in these trying times. Let's stay connected. If you have any questions or concerns, email me at PastorCurtis@chbconthehill.org. Again, that's PastorCurtis@chbconthehill.org. We want to stay connected with you. Reach out to us, email us, let us know how we can be of a blessing or a service to you, and we'll try to get back to you as soon as we can. Thank you so much for joining with us today. God bless you and have a blessed and prosperous and healthy week. Take care.